Hello and welcome to another Magic Arena gameplay video. Today we're taking a look at another standard deck as part of my ongoing budget series here on Channel Fireball. And for today's budget deck, all we need are 8 common wildcards, 8 uncommons, and 7 rares. And the reason we don't need a ton of wildcards for this one is because it's basically an upgraded version of the new green-white starter deck. So if you have a brand new account, you'll eventually unlock a new green-white starter deck that has a lot of the pieces in it already. And if you already had the previous starter decks, I'm being told that somewhere in August, people will get access to the new starter decks as well. But our green-white life gain deck is quite straightforward, a lot of life gain synergies and a lot of life gain payoffs. So let's start out at 1 mana with our full playset of Cleric class, the 1 mana class enchantment, saying if you would gain life, you gain that much life plus 1 instead. If we level it up to level 2 for 4 mana, whenever we gain life we can put a +1/+1 counter on target creature we control, and on level 3 for 5 mana we can return a creature card from our graveyard to the battlefield and we gain life equal to its toughness. Then we also have the full playset of Soulmander. This is one of these arena exclusive cards, and we've got a few other arena exclusives in the deck, so this deck will only be legal in best of one standard. And Soulmander, a very useful creature as a 1/1 human cleric that can tap to gain 1 life, so a great enabler for our various synergies. Then at 2 mana we've got another arena exclusive with the Hallowed Priest, a 2 mana 1/1 human cleric, saying whenever we gain life, put a +1/+1 counter on Hallowed Priest. And then the new addition from Adventures in the Forgotten Realms, the Moondancer, a 2 mana 2/2 legendary elf cleric, saying whenever we gain life, put a +1/+1 counter on it, and we get to scry 1 as well. So very similar to the Hallowed Priest. Then we also have the full playset of Prosperous Innkeeper, a 2 mana 1/1 citizen, that when it enters the battlefield creates a treasure token to help us ramp, and whenever another creature enters the battlefield under our control, we get to gain 1 life. And then we also have two copies of Druid class with a very useful level 1 ability, saying whenever a land enters a battlefield under our control, we gain 1 life. So between Druid class, Innkeeper, and Soulmander, we've got a lot of cheap ways to incrementally gain life to enable our various synergies. And then all the way on level 3, we can also turn one of our lands into a creature with power toughness equal to the number of lands we control. Then at 3 mana we've got a full set of Lurking Roper, a 4/5 that doesn't untap during our next untap step, but whenever we gain life we can untap the Lurking Roper, so that's not going to be a problem in this deck. And then our rare wild card is going to be spent on Righteous Valkyrie. You get one in one of the starter decks, so only need to craft 3 more copies for a 2/4 Angel Cleric with Flying, saying whenever another Angel or Cleric enters the battlefield under our control, we gain life equal to that creature's toughness, and there's a lot of Clerics in the deck already, and as long as we have at least 27 or more life, our creatures get +2/+2, so a very useful Anthem effect that we can get to quite easily. And then we also have the full set of Priest of Ancient Lore, another Dwarf Cleric, and when it enters the battlefield we gain 1 life and draw a card, and it's a 2/1. And then topping off our curve we've got two copies of Valkyrie Harbinger. You get one copy in one of the starter decks, only need to craft one more, and it's a 4/5 Angel Cleric with Flying and Lifelink, and at the beginning of each end step, if you gained 4 or more life this turn, you get to make a 4/4 white Angel creature token with Flying and Vigilance. And then the mana base includes 4 of the Branchloft Pathway. You also get one in the starter deck, so only need to make 3 more. And then we've got 9 basic forests and 11 basic plains. Then I also want to remind you that this video is brought to you by Channel Fireball, in particular U-Box We Buy, the easiest way to sell your magic cards. Just throw them into a box, CFB does the sorting, the grading, the pricing, and you get your cash fast and easy. So head on over to channelfireball.com/U-Box We Buy and be sure to use the code LVD to let them know that I sent you. So that's our deck, now let's jump into some games and see how the deck does. Alright, we're on the play with a keepable hand. Innkeeper providing the treasure so we can cast one of our white spells, and then hopefully we can pick up a plane soon. Put on black white, there's our planes. Still gonna play Innkeeper first, and then could play the cleric class, can wait until next turn to maybe play it before playing something else out. Opponent's got their own Moondancer, some Abzan color deck. Alright, so we've got a couple options here. The most mana efficient play that doesn't use my treasure, I guess, is just a Priest of Ancient Lore. Although I do miss out on the Hallowed Priest picking up some +1 counters in the meantime. So we could go Hallowed Priest plus Soulmender, and then wait on the Cleric class since it doesn't really help me put extra counters on the Priest right away. So let's do that. And then Soulmender's an extra consistent source of life gain. Opponent playing black means they might have access to better removal spells than we do, as another Snarl comes into play. Alright, they've got the Righteous Valkyrie. Land is good. So, Cleric class into Priests. And we can attack and activate Soulmender before damage. Alright, so next turn I can level up my Cleric class, which also represents a lot of extra counters. And if we can keep the opponent's life total low, the Valkyrie is a lot less threatening. Retribution. Alright, it's gonna make an Angel. And next turn, those Angels can wreak havoc on our board. So we're probably going to lose the Soulmender and the Innkeeper. So if I can get one of these above, let's see, is it 2 power? Yeah, if we can get one of them to 2 power, they won't be able to kill it with a Valkyrie at least. So that's worth considering with a Cleric class. And I can even wait to activate the Soulmender in response to whichever creature they try and kill. So I think that means just level up Cleric class right now. And then attack with Hallowed Priests. They don't have a good double block, because we can put 2 counters on Hallowed Priests, so they're probably going to take it. But I'm not going to use a Soulmender until next turn. And then we can save whichever creature they try and kill with a Righteous Valkyrie, because it specifically needs power less than the Angel's power. They will get to kill something with the 4/4 Angel, which also has Vigilance, so that can attack before using the ability. Another Innkeeper. And our opponent's just gonna attack with both. Opponent with an Inscription, destroying my Hallowed Priest, unfortunately. I was gonna start diversifying and putting my counters on the Ancient Lore anyway. Although they still have an Angel they can activate. Takes out Soulmender. Alright, so we're pretty far behind now. Next turn, the opponent's Angels also gain double strike. But let's try and recover with Innkeeper plus Soulmender. And then I'm probably going to keep the level 3 Cleric class to bring back Harbinger if that gets answered. And then another counter on the Priests. And we'll make it one more, so opponent cannot trade with Moondancer and Innkeeper. Opponent chumps. They might have another Moondancer in hand. Alright, so next turn we can play Harbinger. And that's gonna generate an Angel right away. And there's a backup Moondancer. So I'm gonna take 12 damage here. Ooh, Disciple making me discard Harbinger. Well, we can still reanimate it with a Cleric class at least. but that's unfortunate. 6/6 Moon Dancer. Alright, opponent's empty handed at least. And yeah, we'll reanimate our angel. Gain a ton of life. And where do we put those counters? Can always put more counters on Harbinger later. Don't have to do it now necessarily. So I guess we'll keep growing the priests. And attack with Ancient Lore. Opponent's gonna chump. That's fine. And then, yeah, we should have gained 4 life here, so we can pass and make an angel. Which will gain a bunch more life. And sure, we'll diversify a little bit. So we don't put all our eggs in one basket. And yeah, our opponent explodes. Valkyrie Harbinger is just gonna take over the game from here. Sweet, on to the next one. Alright, we're on the play, and we've got a pretty exciting hand, assuming we can hit a couple land drops. Yeah, I'll try it. The two copies of Righteous Valkyrie act as life gain triggers for the Hallowed Priest. Could even benefit us to not play the Hallowed Priest until we have Valkyrie in play. And now that we drew Innkeeper, that's going to be a pretty straightforward Innkeeper on turn 2. And then next turn we might play the Valkyrie, or we could save our treasure to eventually play Harbinger. Not interested in blocking the Javelineer. Fireblade Charger. If they have a Village Rite, they could sacrifice it to finish off the Innkeeper. And looks like that's happening here. Nope, just a Blood Chief's Thirst. Okay. Well, doesn't look like I'm gonna get to 6 mana anytime soon, so I think we just run out of Righteous Valkyrie. And then hope to draw land to play another one. If not, we can play Hallowed Priest, which will still trigger the Valkyrie. So opponent's attacking. Representing some sort of combat trick, maybe a burn spell after they deal 2 damage if we block. Don't think I'm interested in taking that risk. Village Rites to sack the 1/1. And a Grim Wanderer, 5/4, also goblin. So our opponent might be kind of a goblin tribal deck in black-red. Moondancer seems like a better play than Hallowed Priest, as it'll help me scry towards a third land. And since I'm probably not blocking with Valkyrie, we might as well attack. If we can get double Righteous Valkyrie going, we'll be in pretty good shape. For now, I'm fine taking it. Battlecry Goblin. And there's our third land to the rescue. And we'll keep a plains on top. Alright, am I still interested in attacking? I can probably take a hit next turn from the Battlecry Goblin. And then use our life gain to kind of win the race. One is also down to 12 in the meantime. So if I were to block the 1/1, even if they pump, there's going to be a little bit short, so I think this is relatively safe compared to the Charger, which deals 1 extra damage. So if they have a pair of Goblins, for instance, to give the team +2 power, we still don't lose the Valkyrie. Another Battlecry Goblin. So Can go Cleric class into Hallowed Priest to trigger the team. Soulmender probably not needed. Lurking Roper's not a bad blocker. It's not a cleric, so it doesn't trigger a Righteous Valkyrie. So, is it really necessary at that point? Maybe not. And then I have 10 damage here. Might want to keep my creatures back now to an extent. Moondancer is a pretty reliable blocker. I don't mind trading the Hallowed Priest for the Grim Wanderer. So maybe just attack with the Valkyries, which I'm not going to put in harm's way. Opponent's going to get two Goblin Tokens though. Yeah, maybe we have to hit the brakes here and then try to win the late game with our double Cleric class. Because double Battlecry Goblin can enable some powerful attacks. Opponent turns the team sideways. They only have single red, so they can only pump once or play a pair of goblins. So, Hallowed Priest in front of Grim Wanderer. Block the 1/1s with Valkyries. And then Moondancer in front of a Battlecry Goblin looks good. And our opponent explodes. Alright, sweet. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the draw with a nice hand. Triple Innkeeper to enable Hallowed Priest. So gonna play at least two Innkeepers before playing a Hallowed Priest is my guess. And turn 2 Innkeeper enables two drops on turn 3. So that curves out nicely. And yeah, then we're hoping to draw more Hallowed Priests. Moondancer would be excellent. As we see Magda from our opponent. That might be worth blocking with Innkeeper. Don't want Magda to get out of hand. So opponent's red-green with a bit of white. Opponent gets their treasure as well. And it's gonna be the Beloved Ranger making a 1/1 Hamster token. Okay, so I can go Innkeeper into Hallowed Priests. And then next turn, before playing my lands, we can play Druid class. Gotta hope the Hallowed Priest sticks around. Pull off the Ranger attacks, we'll take 3. And Targonar, the legendary Gnoll. Okay. Gotta hope to draw a few more spells here. At least our lands still enable Druid class, which will grow the Priest as well. But our opponent's creatures are quickly gonna get larger than the Hallowed Priest. Targonar attacks can double its power and toughness, so don't have a good block on it. Soulmender is decent, so play land. Can level up my Druid class as well. And then next turn we can be attacking with a large land. Will be a 6/6. Unless we draw an extra land along the way. And I'm happy enough keeping the Hallowed Priest on defense. So we'll see how the opponent deals with an 8/8. Red-green's gonna struggle to do that, but White might have a few answers. As we see the Elf Ranger. Moondancer is great. Could have been a reason to hold an extra land to get an extra life gain trigger. But I think we'll be alright. Righteous Valkyrie's excellence. And then I could still activate level 3 here if I wanted to. If I use both treasures, I can even attack. Yeah, I guess I don't really need those treasures for anything else at this point. And are we attacking? The land's only gonna get bigger next turn. I'm gonna get close to the 27 threshold, so I think we wait until our land gets a bit bigger. Now if our opponent does somehow kill Hallowed Priest with the legend here in play, that's gonna pick up a lot of plus one counters, so we're gonna be in trouble. So hopefully that doesn't happen. Hoffrey can reanimate the opponent's creatures. Although the token is also legendary, so it's fine if that comes back. Same with Minsk. So this seems fine. And end of turn, can still use Soulmender. Alright, so Valkyrie comes down. We gain 2. So we're at 27 or more. And another Valkyrie I'll take. Probably still gonna play defense. And then we can start attacking with our flyer next turn. So our opponent's deck most likely playing Bard class, judging from all the legendaries. Still attacking. So not exactly sure what to make of this. This can essentially deal 10 damage. Well, let's make some blocks. This probably goes here. We can put our lands, let's see, Targonar can double its power up to at least 6. Something like this. Could even block with a Valkyrie, I guess. Might get punished by a pump spell, although we still have Soulmender to gain more life if needed. Yeah, something like this looks okay. Maybe I shouldn't be putting the Valkyrie in harm's way. But I also don't want to lose life and go below the threshold. Targonar comes back. And they had another one. Alright. That's fine. And Valkyrie number 2 should seal the deal here. Cleric class seems good. And we can start attacking We'll send in Righteous Valkyrie and how about Moondancer? Hallowed Priest probably just gets chum blocked by the token, but I guess that's okay too. Sure. Keep one creature back to block. Opponent chumps. And next round we can probably swing with the team. Another Beloved Ranger. And an Arnie Broken Brow. Not sure about these attacks. I guess our opponent just wants to get them back with Hoffrey. I'm at 38, so I can easily take a bunch of damage. Opponent's got 4 blockers at 14 life. So if they block my 4 largest creatures, they are still taking lethal. So, yeah, I guess I'll take 11. And then next turn, I should still be fine. And attack with the team. Opponent's got 4 blockers. So yeah, there we go. Our opponent's legendary deck couldn't quite go over the top of all our life gain synergies. On to the next one. Alright, we're on the draw with a fine hand. Moondancer into Priest. Blue Reds might have a way to deal with the Moondancer here, but we've got a backup. And then I'm probably just gonna play the Roper turn 3. Innkeeper's also tempting. I'll go with the Roper first. That resolves. And then next turn I'm liking Innkeeper into Moondancer, which will untap the Roper, trigger the Moondancer. Ooh, I see. So opponent a giant tribal deck. Still fine attacking into it. So opponent can trade if they want. Takes it. And don't need more lands. So next turn I can play the Druid class before playing my lands to get an extra life. Take it from there. Uh-oh. Battle, Frost and Fire. Well, at least the Roper survives. And I think we have to trade here. Alright, Cleric class is a good one. So what's my sequencing? Probably Druid class into Priest still. And then I can play the Soulmender now. I think it's worth it, because then next turn I can play the Cleric class, get it to level 2, and use the Soulmender to get an extra counter. Yeah, Battle, Frost and Fire is a rough one if we can get a creature large enough. Shadow Skull Charger. We'll take 5. So So I can play Cleric class, level it up before playing my Lance, so the Druid class also gets an extra counter. And we'll hit for 4. Don't know if we can count on the priest blocking the charger next turn. Right, Squash is gonna take it out. And yeah, the Battle of Frost and Fire also quite synergistic with Squash. So this game's not looking great. Innkeeper. So I can bring back a creature from the dead, which would probably be Moondancer. So I can play the Innkeeper first and use the treasure. And then we'll just make the Moondancer large enough so it can hopefully survive future burn spells. Harbinger is great. Definitely keep that. And then I should probably activate Soulmender now so they can squash in response. Alright. So we've got an 8-8. Hopefully that will stick around. Rebuke kill Soulmender, draws a card with Agar. And Glimpse for card advantage. Alright. They can Glimpse again. And our opponent foretells a card. Not sure what that could be. So can I gain 4 life this turn? I gain 2 from the Innkeeper. And that's it, so I'm not going to be gaining the 4 we want. And then Squash deals 6 damage, so I think I'm better off just putting more counters on the Moondancer at that point. And Soulmender isn't terrible, but I think we've got better draws. And Trelsara can attack. Opponent chumps. Crush the weak. Kills Innkeeper, draws a card with Agar. And another Battle Frost and Fire finishes off Harbinger. And Agar draws again. Well, gotta hope they don't have a Rebuke 2 here. That would be a disaster. Squash, ouch. Well, that was a blowout. Lost our entire board. So I can play a Roper or I can turn on my lands and hit for 6. I think that's probably my best bet here. Oh, never mind, we still need to level up our Druid class one more. Alright, well, that makes it easy. Yeah, Agar putting in a lot of work. Another Squash draws another card. Yeah, we can't survive many of these 2-for-1s. Another Calamity Bearer, so Agar can hit for 6. Now I can turn on my lands. So I can do that before playing my lands, so we get a counter on it. I guess I want to animate my planes here. And if I attack for 8, opponent could take it, and then they have 6 times 2, 12 on the way back at least. Probably still worth it. Opponent takes it. So we're down to another Calamity Bear. Glim's gonna look for one. Yeah, our opponent hasn't played many giants, but Agar in combination with removal, very good against any creature strategy. Did they find a Calamity Bear? Nope, another Glimpse. So they still get a bunch of looks, so pretty likely that they find one here. Alright, last chance. And there it is. Alright, so that's 24 damage. And we're dead, on to the next one. Alright, we're on the play with a decent hand, missing a 2-drop, but still a reasonable curve. And hopefully we'll be able to get our Harbinger going. Opponents on red. And I'll gain the 1 life. With double Valkyrie, the life gain seems quite relevant. Let's see if that gets countered. So they must have drawn the Frostbite for the turn. Rebuke kills Valkyrie. Well, we've got more Valkyries. Seize the Spoils, discarding Scion. So might be a dice rolling deck. Okay, I think we just double up on Valkyries. And the Innkeeper can also help us ramp towards Harbinger. So next turn, maybe go Cleric class and Innkeeper. There's Delina, so that could combo off at any time, as we know. Could also play the Priest to try and hit my land drop. And it also gets us to 27 right away to pump up the Valkyries. Alright, so those hit for 12. And yeah, we've got a Priest on defense to still block Delina. So, game might be over before we get a chance to play Harbinger. So opponent will need to get pretty lucky here. Alright, they have the Pixie Guide, so there's a non-zero chance we're dead here. But our opponent missed. And yeah, that's game over. Alright, so we get to see our green-white life gain deck in action, and it can definitely hold its own in the standard 2022 format, and also very cheap to put together, and you'll be able to use those Valkyries in plenty of other decks, same with the green-white pathway. So that's going to do it for today's gameplay. Wanna thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed, and as always, have a nice day.